banner on the cross. You know I always have and I always will. That not a tear is wasted. In time you'll understand. I'm painting beauty with the ashes. Your life is in my hands. So when you're on your knees and answers seem so far away, you're not alone. Stop holding on and just be here. Your world's not falling apart, it's falling into place. I'm on the throne. Stop holding on and just be here. Just be here. Just be here. Lift your hands, lift your eyes. In the storm is where you'll find me. And where you are, I'll hold your heart. I'll hold. Come to me, find your rest in the arms of the God who won't let go. So when you're on your knees and answer seems so far away, you're not alone. Stop holding on and just be here. Your world's not falling apart, it's falling into place. I'm on the throne, stop holding on and just be here. Just be here. Just be here. Just be here. Just be here.
There are people in our lives. Sound asleep and too afraid of what might show up while you're dreaming. Nobody, nobody, nobody sees you. Nobody, nobody will believe you. And every day you try to pick up all the pieces, all the memories that somehow never leave you. Nobody, nobody, nobody sees you. Nobody, nobody will believe you.
God only knows what you've been through. God only knows what they say about you. God only knows how it's killing you. But there's a kind of love that God only knows.
God only knows what you've been through. God only knows what they say about you. But God only knows the real you. There's a kind of love that God only knows.
There's a kind of love that there's a kind of love.
You keep a every single secret, so afraid if someone saw them they would leave. But somebody, somebody, somebody sees you. Somebody, somebody will never leave you. God only knows what you've been through. God only knows what they say about you. God only knows how it's killing you. But there's a kind of love that God only knows.
God only knows what you've been through.
Misunderstood and the ones to blame. What if we could start over? We could start over. We could start over.
Oh, for the lonely, for the ashamed, the misunderstood and the ones to blame. What if we could start over? We could start over. We could start over. There's a kind of love that God only knows. God only knows what you've been.
There's a kind of love that God only knows.
dream has died. Like a tree planted by the water, we never will run dry. Just to know you and to make you know me, lift your name on high, shine like the sun, make darkness run and hide. We know we were made for so much more than ordinary life. It's time for us to more than just survive.
four fast.
Let your gentleness be evident to all, the Lord is near. Let your gentleness be evident to all. Let your gentleness.
Good afternoon, everyone. We are so happy to see you here. It's really a reunion. But we'll have more time after the Thanksgiving service, during dinner. Okay, so more time to catch up during that time. So we are also very happy because we are together this afternoon to glorify God's name, because He's the only reason why Davao Christian High School has reached 70 years. Whew, to God be all the glory. Okay, so let us now prepare our hearts as we worship Him, as we magnify His name, as we glorify His name.
Let us sing for joy to the Lord. Let us shout aloud to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before Him with thanksgiving and extol Him with music and song.
For the Lord is the great God, the great King above all gods. In His hands are the depths of the earth, and the mountain peaks belong to Him.
The sea is His, for He made it, and His hands formed the dry land. Come, let us bow down in worship. Let us kneel before the Lord our Maker.
For He is our God, and we are the people of His pasture, the flock under His care.
Oh, Let's continue worshiping him as we sing this old favorite hymn, To God Be the Glory. Continue our worship as we sing songs of praise to our wonderful God.
I sing praises to your name, O Lord, praises to your name.
how great is our God.
The splendor of the King, clothed in majesty, let all the earth rejoice, all the earth rejoice. He wraps himself in light, and darkness tries to hide, and trembles at his voice, trembles at his voice. How great
good afternoon, everyone. It's wonderful to see all of you here as we celebrate God's goodness to Davao Christian High School. May I invite everybody to please rise as we read God's Word. If you may, please just look at your bulletin. This is called the bulletin, your program sheet. At the front is our theme verse for the past 5 years. And let's read this together. Colossians 2:7. Let your roots grow down into Him, and let your lives be built on Him. Then your faith will grow strong in the truth you were taught, and you will overflow with thankfulness. Shall we pray? Father, our hearts are filled with thankfulness today. And we just say, to God be the glory. You are the God Almighty. You are the God Provider. You are the God who protects. You are the God who guides. You are the God who loves. You are the God who is gracious and merciful. and we praise you. As we celebrate the 70th founding anniversary of Davao Christian High School, we can only say, to God be the glory. We thank you, Lord, because even before the beginning of time, you prepared for us a Savior, Jesus Christ. And because of your love, people were compelled to start the school to share your love to others. People were compelled to start the school to help people grow in Christ-likeness. We thank you for what you have been doing in Davao Christian High School for the last 70 years, from the founding year to the Villa Brille years, to Bahada, to Vimapa, now with CPG. We see your hand at work. We thank you for providing us board members, teachers, faculty, staff. We thank you for providing us parents who support us, for sending students, for providing us donors who generously give to us, and partners who help us in this ministry. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you. Father, as we look back at the 70 years, there are so many things we could point to where we say, wow, the Lord has been good. This time, if not for the Lord, we would not have gone through that. That time, it was just the Lord who has been gracious. Another time, it was the Lord at work. Really, Lord, it has always been you at work in the last 70 years. We thank you that we could gather together today as a DCHS family to celebrate your goodness. And we pray, Father, as we share, as we reminisce, we will all be forced to say, to God be the glory. Honor our worship today. Our hearts are filled with thanksgiving because great things you have done. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Please be seated. Thank you.
Thank you. Wonderful message of the song. I think the theme and the central theme of our gathering this afternoon is thanksgiving. All God's people say, amen, amen. Thanksgiving. Simple, but very deep. Challenging. We think it's easy to do that, but it's deeper than that. When I entered the hall of Davao Christian High School, brings a lot of memory. There are many mistakes in life, but one thing is not a mistake is when you built Davao Christian High School. To God be the glory. Chitsapni, that is 70 years. You preach anniversary at 50, 60, 70 something. Because 70 years old is no longer a joke. It taught us a lot of things, and it's still teaching us. Today, I look at you, I'm deeply, deeply humbled. Let your roots grow down into Him, and let your lives be built on Him. Then your faith will grow strong in the truth that you were taught, and you will overflow with thankfulness. My dear brothers and sisters, as we celebrate Davao Christian High School's 70th anniversary, there are two emotions in my heart. We stand before the Lord humbled and grateful. Amen. Humbled and grateful. Humbled because it is crystal clear that it is not our work, it is God. Grateful because after all, the many realities of life, very fresh, the COVID pandemic, we are still here. To God be the glory. Mom Franny told me that my time limit is 40 minutes in the introduction. The program is very simple but deep. The prayer of Arthur, I really felt, came from the heart, not from the notes. Your background, ganiha bitaw, murag young living, nindot kayo. 70, abi kog na maligya mog oil dire. Beautiful design, kog familiar ning background ay. Murag young living. And I saw my teachers, I only remember two, maybe three, basig mang luod ang uban. I'll try my best. One, Ma'am Marasigan is always there. Mrs. Wesan, are you here? Ma'am Wesan, wala. Shansi Shulan, those are the teachers I know. Because believe me, I'm now God's up. See, hey, I'm now 54 years old, and please don't spread that. I still dream about the grace of To Siulan Xianxi, who let me pass in my Chinese. Lord have mercy. Give me some latitude of nostalgia, you know. Our batch is batch 85, the source of both blessing and frustration. And the notorious batch of all, but we contributed to the board. Brian To is one of you. So God be praised. The gospel is at work. I checked if Brian is here. He said, mo absent ko bay? Nah. Absent ko ng amaw. Pero appeal siya sa batch 85. I remember. Places are special, like Bahada. Each time I pass by there, di ba? Magi mo sa Bahada? Dili malikayan ba? Memories are powerful. Names are powerful. Si Bibi, si Bik, si Gwardia, si Bik, si Helen Samontina, si Nong Boy, si Nong Poli. Maayo ni si Nong Boy, no? Kay maayo ang iyang integrity ba? Kaya nasayod ba mo sa una nga ang test paper siya, mana ang tig mimyo. Di ba? You want to pass? Nong Boy. Kung kurakot ni si Nong Boy, tapos, mimyo mana, no? Of course, I miss Mrs. Ugay. Who would not miss Mrs. Herminia Ugay, whose English is flawless? And at her age that time, the only teacher in Davao Christian High School who is allowed to wear miniskirt. You remember Mrs. Ugay? Ah, grabe. Mudi kwatro ganito. Kung di good me, matintal ni mo, ma'am. Sa ngalan ni Jesus. Mrs. Ugay and the very strict ninja Chinese teachers who loved us. I remember one, I hate one subject in Chinese, Thank God it's abolished. It's called swansuit. Amsiatsu bolo. Swansuit is math. Thank God it's done. Memories are powerful, and I see batchmates. Batch 85 man mino. Ang older, ang younger sa mo, 84. And batch 85 and batch 83 are best friends. Am I right? No? The two batches. Because we beat you twice during intramurals. No? We were champion second year. We were champion third year. Oh God, what happened to this batch? You were, ay, gipanglampurnas namo mo sa basketball. Pero pag abot sa fourth year na pildi, nagigabaan abot ang mong batch. Wonderful gathering this afternoon. And yet, we are reminded by the word of God to be grateful. Such a feeling of humility and gratitude should not just stay a feeling. It should become a commitment and a way of life. Amen. A commitment and a way of life. Becoming thankful as a way of life is not easy. It requires you three things. First, it must be a conviction. Not just superstition, but a conviction. The pandemic taught us to be grateful. Tama ba? I don't know what happened in your life, but blessed are those who are grateful. They shall overcome. And Davao Christian High School is not a school of academics only. This is a school where gratitude is modeled and gratitude is taught. Number two, gratitude must be a choice. Spiritual choice, no one can choose that for you. Someone will choose that. A lot of us are all Christians in Davao Christian High School because since kinder, we were shown the film Burning Hell. Siyarog di ka ma-Christian, ana, impyerno gigipakita sa imo since grade one. Ako'y amigo sa nakabay, kapila man dyan tamo dawat sa Ginoo mo, forward, ta sa kada spiritual emphasis. Kung bahala na, basta sure, siyaro, sa kaikapitong forward, wag yung isa diyan tinood. It's a choice. And choices are not made easily. In fact, the rule of choice is, you cannot have both, one must go. You cannot have both, one must go. And then comes the heavy word for Thanksgiving. It becomes a commitment. At the funeral of Mr. Marasigan, I attended, and I remember clearly the sermon, the message of Nangliling. In everything, give thanks, for this is the will of God. And that's not easy. Because not all of us is having a good time in life. Copy that? Not everybody is happy. Not everybody is favored. And to the teachers, may God have mercy on your soul. Because the students that will enroll in Davao Christian is far more from being ideal. Family is complicated. Marriage are being destroyed. This country is in a ruin. You see? How can you say, give thanks with a grateful heart? I remember, in everything, give thanks. Mabong ko na akong tema sa akong wali karong hapon. This is what Paul meant. The text was written by Paul. He wrote that to a church in Colossae. And you know what? He never had a chance to go to Colossae. Never. Heard about them, wrote them something. And then if you look at the text, seems to me that overflowing with thankfulness is last. Can you look? Wala ba muna intriga? The last part is overflowing with thankfulness. By the way, just look at the verse. It's not just thankfulness, it's overflowing. May pagkakaiba po yung just thank you, but overflowing. Which means there is a living source that keeps us giving thanks while we accept and without denial the realities of life. I come here today as a family member. That's why Inang Franny, Ma'am Franny, the forever Franny, the eternal principal of Davao Christian High School, said, dili na taka introduce ha, di na kinahanglan, ma'am. Do you agree with me? We feel like family today. Tama ba? It's just coming home. Family. And because we're family, I'm at home. I have just one thing to say to you. Maybe three or more. No, maybe 14. No. I'm a Baptist preacher, so three would be enough. But since I finished from the fourth square, maybe four would do. Ang pangutana karong hapon, mga igsuon, our question is, yes, overflowing with thanksgiving. But the real question is, how do you do that? Saan mo pagpasalamat, Pastor, na matay akong bana? Saan mo pagpasalamat nga? You know, it's hard to say, thank God I was spared from COVID. Many were not. Copy that? Thank God my family is happy. How about those who are not happy? Thank God that our Christians survive. How about the school that closed? We said no. Because Thanksgiving is not meant to be biased by your favor. Thanksgiving is focused on a person, the Lord Jesus Christ. I don't know how many more years God will grant me to preach His word. I committed a lot of mistakes. Pero from time and again, as I stand in the pulpit, podium, wherever God wants, ako'y promise. The theme of my preaching will always be the Lord Jesus Christ. The theme of my message will always be the Lord Jesus Christ. How do you live a thankful life? Remember three things from your text. Number one, we need to have spiritual roots in Christ. We need to have spiritual roots in Christ. Christ is the reason of our gratitude. Amen. Christ is the object of our gratitude. Christ is the strength of our gratitude. Because there are times, lisod kayo pasalamat. So many times I have seen enough raw realities in life that could even question God. But the same Christ, tsuyaso, is the strength of our thanksgiving. Would you like to remember that He is the reason? Siya po ang dahilan, bakit ako nagpapasalamat. Number two, He's the object. Well, a lot of success in Davao Christian High School. You are surrounded with success. You see, the building is nice. More building in CPG. Well, we all started in a place called Villa Abrile beside a funeral parlor. Can I ever? Diba? The kinders Davao ang tapad ato, Cosmo. Ay, Ginoo ko. You remember that? Davao Evangelical Church? Beside Cosmo. Screen lang talaga ang palagpagitan. O mo na, magdula mi sa una. Murag, sanay na kami, may mga lungon diha, may mga... You know, you did not research what a traumatic place to start a kindergarten beside a funeral parlor. By now, that will be called child abuse. Pero God is sovereign. Villa Abrile Street will never be an ordinary street for me, such as Bahada. I always stop by there. And nag-survive na lang diha nga building ka ng kay Kuya Greg, ang GT. That is a Caltex, the same yesterday, today, and forever. Each time I look at, diha man to ang school, no? I'm grateful. Buildings go down, people change, but Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Try to refocus your thanksgiving from the good things that happened to me to the good Christ that allows all of this. Amen. Number two, take note. We are not just talking about polite thanksgiving or guilt thanksgiving. We're talking about Christian thanksgiving. Davao Christian High School. You know what holds on that name? Christ. Kwa ang Christ, Davao Ian High School. Kinsa si Ian? I was taught, without Christ, I-A-N should mean I am nothing. This afternoon, trouble with me, the past, present, and the future of DCHS is always about Jesus Christ. Amen. It's all in His hands. The blessings of Davao Christian High School today, God gave you good leadership. And I don't mean to flatter. Pastor Arthur Yap, it's a gift from Davao Christian, from God to Davao Christian High School. To the Board of Trustees, please increase his salary right now. Because if he is a gift and you pay him well, you are doing injustice. No, wala may eksterya ni Arthur. Mula noon si Autio. Dato naman si Arthur. Pero, ma, you have a leader. That's God's gift. You have teachers who are committed. Sa mga teacher diri, ako ko natingala jud ko ba, ang mga batan-on nga teacher. Naalagi gihapon mo diri. Wow, I thank God. Plan to stay here for more years. Plan to die here. Choose a spot where you want. Plan to the Board of Trustees. Come siya to thank God for serving Davao Christian High School. You did not lose. The policies you make, the decisions you make shape lives. You won't see that. But as I look at my picture, the kindergarten award I got, the Board of Trustees is still there. You will be forever in the memories of the children. Okay. So, maskin analag diploma, no? Ministry biya na? No? Of course, one request. Of all the medals you are giving in Davao Christian High School, please do not omit the loyalty award. Please. That's the only award I got from this school. Since kindergarten to... Uy, ayaw mo katawa. Kay lisod kayo ang loyalty award. The hardest award. Nah, you will never get a loyalty award kung na-office ka. Tinood na ba? Naka-atraso sa office, cancel ng loyalty ni mo. Na-office biya mi, eh? Ano naka-award mo to? Oh, I remember you had a team, Grace Alone. That's the nice word. I'm now on my second. I said kanina, deep roots in Christ. Number two, we need a consistent spiritual reminders to focus on Christ. May I remind you of the past? The past taught us what happened when a Christ-centered dream becomes a concrete fulfillment. Amen. It all started with, I'll tell you a reality. Walay tago-tago. Research if you want. Very seldom for a church who runs a school to reach 70. Research that. Very seldom. Any church run school, once it's prosperous, mag-away yun ng board. May patungwa pa eh. Kwarta, okay ra. But you reach 70. And 70 is not just a years of roses. There were many hurts. There were many disagreements. But why is this school surviving? Because it was built on a Christ-centered dream. Listen to the testimony of the students. We met Christ. I remember a time in Davao Christian High School when the Holy Spirit came down and there was sweeping revival in Bahada. Our speaker was Reverend Greenacre. Something I will never forget. Songs of the Spiritual Emphasis Week. I ask you a question. When was the last time God came down and reminded us that this school belongs to Him? Pandemic reminded you, this is the school of Jesus. Amen. Were the teachers paid during the pandemic? You are very silent. Amen. Again, I ask the question, were you paid? But you did not work. No, you work at home. Kami bitaw sa church, natingala pud mi ba? Ningon among treasurer pastor na mamo text ba nga may sweldo na, agoy hallelujah. Because this is the school of Jesus. Number two, the present, ang karon sa Ilonggo, Subong, karon sa Bisaya. Mao nang giawayan na mo ni cutie sa bago pa ming minyo. Kaya ang Ilong, ako Bisaya man, karon. Yang kay sa Ilonggo karon basta iba, but what I'm saying is present. Now, subong, okay? Here's the outline. The present is teaching us not to forget what Christ can do to a Christ-centered school. Amen. What Christ can do. Amen. What Christ can do. The future, tomorrow, what will Davao Christian be? Oh, that's scary. Will there be a future? Diba? Nakita ko si Pastor, Professor Joel, the most, I think he's the next senior teacher, no? And nagtungkod naman siya. Unko, sir, I love Joel. Unko, Joe, wala pa ka na principal, nagtungkod na ka. What would be the future? I am not a futuristic person. I'm even afraid to peep into the future. Pero maunyo, the future is teaching us. Are you ready for this? The future is teaching us to overcome our fears. Amen. Overcome our fears. How? By deepening our faith in Christ and making us, here we go, grateful releasers instead of greedy, grumpy controllers. The future teaches us to deepen our faith in Christ. When your faith is deep, your gratitude overflows. Amen. And no person can truly be thankful if that person is a controller. Makatabang ang blood control, birth control, ang sa pang-control. But if you are a controller, you can never overflow with thanksgiving. So, do not grow old to be a controller. Be a releaser. Children are not yours forever. Manigawang, magpamilya, release. Time will come, your good teachers must go to another school. You know, we need to let go. Soon retirement is here. I told our church at 60, mo retire na ko. Katong layo pa, isog pa kay ko, mo retire na ko. Pero kanang gakaduol na, lahi ang feeling. Para bang unsa man eh, mag-anaan na akong latas tiyong ko. Retire na. Pero you know what? If your focus is Christ, you will overcome your fear. Amen. We need consistent reminders. Motoo ba magdili? We are forgetful people. Copy that? Are you having problems with your memories lately? Some of you have sharp memories. Ako, I have. Mangita kag salamin. Naligo gani ko. Nagsuot naman ako brief. Nagsuot pa ko kaduha. Kung ino. Sobra na ni karon memory lapse. Totoo yan. Nag-shampoo na ako. Para bang, nag-shampoo na ba ako? Paano nakakatawa, no? Pero totoo. Hindi po yan dementia or just early signs of what, but spiritually, we are forgetful people. That's why we need anniversaries like this to be reminded. Amen. As much as possible. Saon na to ni Hautyo, bahala na ka. Try your best that let us keep gathering together. Diba? Not only when pandemic taught us we really need each other. What do I mean by that? Let your lives be built on Him. Can we read that part? Let your lives be built on Him. Then your faith will grow strong in the truth you were taught. One more time. Let your lives be built on Him. Then your faith will grow strong. Truth you were taught. You know, the word then is a very powerful word. It means something happened because of this then. Because of this overflowing thanksgiving. And then the word you were taught is even more humbling because you don't know everything. Huaseng Hia Boksu, Pastor Moreno Lim, who is now with the Lord, I remember gave me my first Bible. Diba the Gideons give Bible every year? I remember clearly, kadakodakos daba Christian, when the Gideons distributed the Bible, I was absent. But Pastor Lim, with his eternal jeep, all the limbs, sakto dito. Isuka ito nga jeep, no? Nga matay na lang mga hapon, buhi nga po itong jeep ni Moreno. Oh, Arnel, grade 4, grade 5, is looking for you. Here's red Bible. Something. Mrs. Gonzaga taught my first song. Huh? I'm so happy and here's the reason why Jesus took my burdens all the way. Mrs. Gonzaga. Mrs. Wesson taught me to be a pastor. Diba? Wala manggut si Ma'am Wesson. Ah, may anak na rin, no? Isulti kay Ma'am. Isulti kay ng algebra, eh? Is there a way to cancel that? That's not really related to life. I used to put in my grabe good na si Elizabeth. Ma'am, simplify. Nah. You know, even if you don't believe in God, be in her class, you will become a believer. But Jesus saves. Sulat po si Ma'am Wesson. Di pa man siya Christian ato eh. Pagsulod, mauday, stricto. Katong na Christian na siya, mas na stricto. Tayo Jesus saves. Students should study too. Ay, nako. Miss Ninang Marlene Bringas. Who will forget that woman who... Ma'am Marlene, pag-birthday na to, mag-lipstick, no? Child abuse na naroon, ha? So, nadili. Birthday. Who is birthday today? Lipstick kasi Marlene Leticia Bringas, to be complete. Who would forget Mrs. Priscilla Nepomuceno? Oh, the Ilonga teacher who said, "Hi, class, if you die tonight, are you gonna go to heaven?" Huh. Grabe na silang pressing. Kakita po na siya mga duwindi-duwindi dito sa... Who would forget? Meaning, we need to be taught even how to be thankful. Copy that? If not by teachers, then by life. If not by life, then directly by God. Here's my prayer for Davao Christian. If Christ is our focus, then grace will be our lifestyle. Amen. Now I know, Brian To should have been suspended for the rest of his life. Third year siya. Balhin siya sa Davao Central. It's Chinese school. Ang atong karibal ba? Chinese school, no? Pero, layan. Eh! Balhin si Brian dito. Pero hangyo good towns, Brian. Lord, with the pleading from Mrs. Marasigan, pag-graduate jud ko diri sa fourth year. So fourth year, bumalik si Brian. Pero ingon ni Ma'am Liling, one mistake, Brian, you're out. Pero Brian made it. Why? Because Mrs. Marasigan showed grace. You know what is grace? You don't deserve it. The enemy of karma is grace. Karma, you do bad, you be bad. Grace, you're bad, but God has still blessed. If you focus on Christ, your lifestyle will be grace. Amen. Number two, if Christ is our focus, here we go, greed will be easily noticed and dealt with. The enemy of a growing school is the desire for profit. I don't know how the board will deal with that, but I'm sure the expenses are high and life is hard, but this is the school of Jesus. Si dane kaki otang, sige si tuya soy otang. Did I say it right, Art? Oh, siyan si Siulan, ha? Tama, ipasadyod ko ni mo. Dili pa na kogi, ha? Wa pa ko nagkogi. Hokyan pa na. Mag-Mandarin gani ko ron. Mandarin ko yan, ha? Ano sa'yo? Eh, Korean na ito. Greed is the enemy of this school. Greed. Is it building or people? Greed. Profit. Wow. But if your focus is Christ, cut other budgets, but stay trusting God. Mabuhi lagi. God will send you donors. God will send you the students you suspended. Coming back, bringing big donation. While the valedictorians are teachers. Ito mga bugoy-bugoy donors. You will be surprised. Do not be afraid. God will provide for Davao Christian High School. Please increase the scholarship for pastor's kid. My children graduated because of that. Thank you very much. We will not forget. Mahal-mahal ba inyong tuition dere, ha? Pero buyag lang, ha? Pero ang scholarship sa mga pastor, salamat, cute ko. Greed is the enemy. But if the focus is Christ, you can deal with it. If Christ is our focus, then God's glory will be our goal in everything we do. Amen. Amen. It's good that Davao Christian is excellent in math, excellent in this. Wonderful. But in the heart of every graduate of Davao Christian High School, to see tuya soe eng ya, God's glory. If Christ is our focus, ito na yung text ninyo, gratitude will overflow. Amen. If Christ is focus, not my sickness, not my problem, not my health, not my misery in life, though that cannot be denied, but if Christ is your focus, you will be amazed. You will be thankful. Amen. Songs like, thank you, Lord, for saving my soul. Christ is your focus. But oneself is focus, goodbye gratitude. And my final word for Davao Christian High School, which is not really final at all. Naapay, final, final, final. We need to be connected spiritual community where gratitude to God became real and incarnational. That's a big word. Connected, not detached. Connected, not just thank you, Lord, but walking testimony. The Word became flesh and dwelt among us. Challenge for Davao Christian. Sana may PowerPoint, may nalang wala. Ako lang basahon. Davao Christian DCHS must be really known as the school of Jesus. Amen. Davao Christian is God's instrument that the community will learn gratitude. Para bang ang gusto ko, basta haud og math, you know, when you were in Ateneo, the teachers would say, are you from Davao Christian High School? You must be good in math. When I went to Ateneo, the teacher said, are you from Davao Christian High School? Yes, ma'am. Why are you not good in math? Ma'am, in everything there is an exemption. But I am good in Bible memory. Good in math. More mang brand sa Christian school, di ba? Good in math. Pero na ako'y gusto i-pray ba? That whenever you meet a thankful person, they will say, taga Davao Christian High School ka, no? Is that nice? Amen? Whenever you meet a person who is light, easy to live with, not uptight, not perfectionist, you're from Davao Christian High School. And the rest from Stella. Because they too are grateful people. Pero dapat, mao na atong brand ba, dili lang haud sa math or nindot ang, attitude, that's what I'm saying. If your attitude is nice, the community would say, taga-Christian school ka no? Davao Christian will be a catalyst of truth and grace. Excellence and humility are good combination. Diba? I'm proud in the Lord. Excellence is not being the best. It's doing your best. This one is a little bit painful, but I know you can bear it. Davao Christian is engaged into the real issues of life, reflecting Christ, becoming flesh. I address to the teachers of Davao Christian, teach your children, the pupils of the school, truth, facts, reality. Equip them to become truth tellers. Because today, it's hard to know which is true, which is lie, and which is called eternal gray. Davao Christian is different, but not detached. You will have 1 month to realize what I've just said. Different, lahi, pero dili detached. Believe me. We are not detached. Mga gising na mga mamamayan, alam ang nangyayari sa bayan. Dahil si Kristo ang kaibahan na ating ibibigay sa ating komunidad. Not just money, not just fame, it's about Christ. So here is the good news. I promise you this is really the real conclusion. Good news, ba? One of my bishop friends said, oh, Pastor Tan, you're a good preacher, but you always end with the bad news. Try to end with the good news. Tama si Bishop. Let's end with the good news so you can smile and digest your food later. If you agree with what I say, say amen. Okay? Pwede ba na? If you agree. If you don't agree, agree na lang para away. Gubot. Good news for DCHS. Christ is the reason why we have Davao Christian High School. Amen. Amen. Christ is the reason. Dili lang na siya. Si Kristo ang dahilan bakit may Davao Christian High School. Christ, this one is really true. Christ is the strength why Davao Christian High School survives all the realities of life. Amen? Christ is the strength. Most times when you have few enrollments and suddenly, yung mga last-minute provisions sa Ginoo, Christ is the strength. Here one, for the Board of Trustees and the policy-making body of Davao Christian High School, Christ is the center and focus of Davao Christian High School. As we struggle to reflect this in our practices and our policies. One of the things I would like to see in Davao Christian High School, brown and yellow, black and white, they are precious in His sight. I would prefer that Davao Christian High School will be known as a Christian school than just a Chinese school. Do you want to read the history below? Sa office ni sa atbang sa perfect of discipline. Yeah, sa silong. Every time I go there, I pass by. Please, I challenge you. Pass by there when you go and pagkaon-taon niya, 1973, something happened in our history. Something happened. Something happened. I'll tell you next 71st anniversary. I'll tell you now. Basta hahaban tayo. Picture eh. 1973, napoy na maayong nahimo si Ferdinand Marcos, no? Dili man tanan, pero kini, credit to whom credit is due. The rest are not good, but this one is good. Martial law declared the Philippines, 1973, you know what the law said? It requires all school to accept non-Chinese. That's it. And then I realized, Kamsia Tzu. That's an edict of a dictator, but God meant it to be good. Because from that time on, Davao Christian High School opened up into something we might be reluctant to open. But thank be to God, if the center is Christ, policies will change. Amen. There will be people who will come in here that you don't like. Color of their skin. The most challenging one is gender. The most challenging one is political leaning. But if this is the school of Jesus, truth is told, but grace abound. I remember we have a classmate from a public school. He transferred in the middle of the school. We were grade 6. We were all kwan kaming mga kutis, alaga ng chinchinso. But this one, guys, from the public school, kasulod siya. But kung kaila pa ko siyang name eh, because the Lord taught me a lesson early that time, grade 6 pa ko. And then I realized that the school of Davao Christian High School must be for all colors. All God's people say, if this is the school of Jesus, not for the rich, for all people. If this is the school of Jesus, then each one will be respected. Catholics will come to our school. I challenge the Christian education. Never bully Catholics. Respect them. There's this crazy teacher, dili dire ha para safe. Ang Catholic dire, ang Christian dire, kini ma imperno, kini ma langit, undangan na ninyo eh. Dili man na dire. Come on. Muslims will come here with their hijabs and their culture. If this is the school of Jesus, I am not asking you to compromise. I'm asking you to respect. Students with dark backgrounds will be here. Sons and daughters of drug lords. Sons and daughters of notorious figures in the community, including notorious pastors, because there are. No, napay pastor nga yawa on og kuan. Mo eskwela dire. Dawatan ninyo because this is the school of Jesus. He or she, hallelujah, is truly a product of Davao Christian High School. Why? Because he is good in math. Ah. Because he excels in business. No. A lot of illegal people in the city are graduates from Davao Christian High School also, just to be fair. He or she is a product of Davao Christian High School because he is true to Christ. We give thanks. Mrs. Judy Foncardas, remember her? I remember Ma'am Foncardas. I don't know if you have noticed. Mama na kay Manang Judy. Bilangon guna na mo. I don't know if you have noticed. Kay Sir Oka, supposing this triangle ay iwan. Si Ma'am Foncardas, no? I was not graduating, but I heard it. Mag-graduate na kasi. Be true. Let the holy watchword ring. Be true to your trust. Be true to your glorious King. Be true. Whether friends be false or few. Whatsoe'er be tied ever at Jesus' side, Davao Christian graduates will always find him true. That is the reason why we give thanks. Be true, let the holy watchword ring. Be true to your trust. Be true to your glorious King. Be true, amen. Be true, whether friends be false or few. Whatsoe'er betide ever at Jesus' side, let him always find us true. To God be the glory. Let us all be true, because our Master is true to us. Amen. Uman na. And by the way,
for the past 70 years, we have clung to our Lord Jesus Christ through ups and downs. As we face the coming years of the ministry of Davao Christian High School, may we continue to be faithful, holding on to our Almighty God. Together, let us affirm our faith in Him. Please stand as able. Let us read this together. We believe in God the Father, Son, Holy Spirit, in the divine inspiration of the Holy Scriptures, as originally given, in the vicarious atonement of the Lord Jesus Christ, which was done through his incarnation, sufferings, death, resurrection, and his ascension, that by grace, through faith, eternal life is given to those who believe in him, and eternal punishment to all who reject him. We accept the doctrine of Jesus Christ as our Savior, Lord, Sanctifier, Healer, and Coming King.
Let's pray. Heavenly Father, it is said that when King David was in his 70s, he reflected and carefully considered his 7 decades of life, a life admixed with turmoil and triumph, And finally, concluding in saying, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In his well-loved psalm, he aptly described how good a shepherd you are to your beloved ones. And he is able to say this of you because throughout his life, he had put his full trust in you, and you have never failed him for his trust, not even once. His life, from a lowly shepherd boy to becoming the greatest king of Israel, is the testament to your loving kindness. Heavenly Father, today we are celebrating the 70th founding anniversary of Davao Christian High School. And as we reminisce its 70 years of existence, how it grew and is now thriving, we cannot help but feel one with King David in saying, Lord, you are the good shepherd of Davao Christian High School. And under your care, it has never been in want. Your provision for its needs has always been sufficient, given at the right time, at your own pace. Thank you, Lord, for your loving kindness. Today, we once again acknowledge that Davao Christian High School is yours, existing for the purpose of furthering your kingdom in this part of the land, for the glory of your name. And we, the Davao Evangelical Church, the School Board of Trustees, the school faculty and staff are your servant. And we once again dedicate ourselves to your service. We'd just like you to know that we are happy to serve you in this school because we love you. May you always find us faithful to your calling. Accept this, our offering, O God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Let us pray. Our eternal God and Heavenly Father, most gracious Lord, King of kings, Lord of lords, indeed, we give you praise. We are here, O Lord, today, looking at 70 years, but we are humbled, humbled by your grace, humbled by your goodness, humbled by your how great and mighty you are. We are humbled before you, Lord. And Lord, we once again look back at the 70 years, but yet, Lord, we look at the present, we look at the future. As we have been reminded today, O Lord, that this school, Davao Christian High School, is the Lord Jesus Christ's. Lord, we consecrate ourselves before you today. Purify us, O Lord. Let nothing that is not of you, O Lord, take root in this school. But what is only of you, O Lord, take root in this school. That Jesus Christ will be the same yesterday, today, and tomorrow as he is, as you are, being the cornerstone of this school. Lord, we pray and dedicate this school once again to you. Your word says, O Lord, blessed is the man who trusts in the Lord, whose trust is the Lord. Blessed is this school who trusts in you and whose trust is the Lord. Lord, we dedicate this school. We dedicate every person that is in this school. And we also dedicate every person that enters through this school, that Lord, only the Lord Jesus Christ be preached, nothing else, nothing more. Keep this school, Lord, from stumbling. Keep this school from drifting from our mission to proclaim the Lord Jesus Christ. Keep this school, Lord, to preach only the pure gospel of Jesus Christ. Keep this school, Lord, from the attacks of the enemy. Deliver us, O Lord. And may this school, Lord, as we look at the 70 years, 70 years is just a small number before you. Yours is eternity, O God. But Lord, you have determined from the past what it is today and what is to come. And so, Lord, we commit to you what is to come unto you. Dedicating this school, Lord, we pray, guide us, O Lord, with your grace. Lead us with your light in Jesus Christ. And as we move forward, let Christ always be before us, beside us, and behind us. And let nothing else be said of Davao Christian High School except to say that this is indeed yours alone. Lord, we pray for greater harvest of souls in the coming years, bringing more people into your kingdom through this school. And Lord, not unto us, but unto you alone, be all the glory, honor, and praise. For this we pray only in the name of our Redeemer, Savior, and Lord Jesus Christ. Amen and amen.
First part of our celebration this afternoon has just ended. We thank God for again 70 wonderful years to Davao Christian High School. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. To God be the glory. We are now going to the second part of our celebration, which is dinner. So we would like to request our guests to please proceed to the quadrangle. But those who need assistance, kindly let our teachers and staff know we have assistants at the back who will need people to help them to go down. For those who are already able, please proceed to the quadrangle area for dinner, which is part two. And then we would like to, of course, invite you back here for the third part of our celebration with our students. They have prepared a lot for you, so we look forward to see you here back after dinner. Thank you, and we will see you in a while. Teachers and staff, kindly await those who need assistance before you go down. Thank you very much.
Cry out to worship. Whose glory?